today I'm making one interactive card with the same kit, and here what I did, I just got the paper with the Simons's die. These are stitch dies, and then this one is simple brown cardstock, and then I cut out two pieces. This one is I gave little bit of mist with the golden color, and another is come with the plaited paper. Again, I cut the heels from same Simons's dies heels, and this sun is from MFT, and I'm planning to use some trees also. So for that I'm using these die. These are three dies from Simons's, and in my last video I told you how I made these trees. So now basically I have to trim down these panels again. So one will act for the sky and one will act for the ground here. So now you can see that there is a little bit of more as I'm using the same die, but this little bit more is just because of the fold, and I want to fold this card really flat. So I'll cut the excess. And for making this pop-up card, I will not use any dies. We'll just use scissors and normal things. Here I'm using dies in the sense of pop-up dies. So now I shouldn't ruin this card. So I'll just cut the excess with scissors, cause I just want to make sure that it's cut properly. Then what I did, I just fold this card, and then I make two cuts. One is smaller and another is deeper. Now if you like to measure them, I'll measure for you. One is a quarter inch left than the other one, and another is an inch. So now when you fold your card and then cut, then you have to open that and then push these front, and then you have to make pinch like thing, and then you have to press them again. Here you can use bone folders, or you can use ice cream sticks, or you can use this thing just by hand also. There you can see the little bit of other marks also, because I'm trying to plan in these, but that trick is not work, so I'll stick with the original one. Now you can see that this will fit it here, and this will act as a sky, and this will fit here. But for these two I need to make same marks to cut it, so that I can place those below the card. So I'll use here a pencil and I will cut those. Now here you can see I'm not using the stitch side here, I'm using the cut side here, so that my card will look more nice. Now you can see I want to add the heel on this side also. So for adding this heel, I have to again do some kind of okay, now you see that I just make these mistakes. So sometimes it's really good to show the mistakes also, so how I can make that happen, because this one is the smaller set slit and this one is the bigger slit. And now when I put this card something like that, and when I make the mark and I turn it, so it become opposite. So what I did now is I just flip the card side and then make a mark. That those dies will really make your life easy, but I will stick to these because I don't have these dies, and many people don't have those. Still they want to do the interactive cards. Now it's time to cut these slits. You can use a craft knife also. I'm using here a scissors, and okay, there is one, and now here the another. Now if you use a craft knife on this, make sure that you're not doing your craft mat here, because I'm using your craft mat. So first of all, remove your craft mat and then only use the knife. So I have these, I make some room here. So now you can see, so I'll just cut this with craft knife. If you want, you can use the scale also for doing this, but these are a little bit smaller, so I'm just using. And again, I will also learn through this process, because I didn't make any card like this. I'm making this card first time, so you can learn with me with my mistakes also. So I cut out these. Now I want to add these panels. In there's these pop-ups. and they should fit properly in those. So now all these die cut pieces are here, so I'll attach all of them and you will enjoy the music. So now it's time to stick this card to the base, and you can skip the this 3-layer card step by adding a little bit more card or pattern paper on both the side, but I love to do this because it will leave me equal kind of border all around. And now you can see this card step is it's not that much thick, so although this card will become a little bit heavier on side. Now for that side, I'll just put ample amount of adhesive here, and then I'll just put this just like that, and then give it a nice press to it. After opening this, you can see this pop-up card is ready, and it's really looking nice. Now what I did, I just stamp these squares in brown color, and then I do here mirror stamping because I want two of them kind of similar, and for that I use the paper smooches stamp, and I will show how I did in another technique video, but it's really easy and simple to do. You can watch Jennifer Maguire's video also, she explained really well. Now here I'm adding this square, and I'm using a liquid glue here. Whenever I have a little bit of doubt that positioning or something like that, I love to use liquid glue. Now you can see this yellow inside the cards, so I have these remaining pieces with me of the cardstock, and I'll add those inside the cardstock. You can skip this you can skip this also, but it's a little bit tricky after adding the main back panel there, so I have to remove that square before, and then I'm kind of here and there manipulating it, so I'll remove this one also. So in this way the liquid glue works really nice because you have a little bit of room to play here. And for outside, we'll try to keep it a little bit simple because inside is a real surprise. So now again, I'll put these and just place this as it is to give some drying time to it. Now here you can see I want to add a little bit of inside to write the message. Now I have this leftover piece from the different project, but you see all these pieces are pretty much kind of dark and you can't write on them, so this one is a little bit nicer that you can write on it, and it will not and I will add this ring also, and it will not give you hodgepodge look on your eyes because all these pattern paper are from one line, so somehow they will match with each other. And then I'll add a little bit of liquid adhesive all around, and just like that. And this is the rings I cut out from the cardstock came with it, and now you can see it's a little bit off center because I want to add something inside, so I will plan to make one. I stamp these nuts icons from the same stamp, and I'll already show the paper smooching techniques that how I did that in the last card making video, which is the part of this, the last card you can say. And then I'll add three of them around it, and I'll speed up the little bit process that how I decorate inside and outside of it. So hold this card in a place. I'm using one of the cardstock, scraps cardstock from here, and I will make this belly kind of thing. And I saw this technique on the long form video and I really like that, and I want to, you know, just to give it a try. So I just make this and then press it a little bit so can it slide really nice up and down. And after doing that, I want to add a little bit of something on this card also. So I had this again, the tree, kind of oval shape kind of tree here. You can cut by hand also, and I'll just add a little bit of glue stick this on the card. And now I'll just put more glue on this side. Now you want to stick this really really flat, because this flap gonna move up and down, so you want to make sure that this will really stick to this. So now you can see I make this belly band, and I just put this tree here, and I'll just make sure that this will move really nicely. I don't want to restrict the movement of this band. And now when the recipient get this and she open it, and that's like, this is the pop-up card. So I hope you like this interactive card.
So this is today's card. I hope you enjoyed it, and if my channel, please do subscribe to it. You can watch the photos of this card on my wall. So you can follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Pinterest also. So until the next crafty project, have a crafty life. Bye.